Hi there, welcome back to Tyranny. It's Judges Day and we are the law in this half-gate part. It's gonna be a hellgate for the Scarlet Chorus. Let's talk to Misery and find out what misery we can bring them. Must be my lucky day. The Crimson Spear cocks her helm hidden face to the side, studying you warily. I get to bathe my Arabella in a Fatebinder's blood. She stomps into a hip-squared crouch and pivots her long spear over her head. As her hand movements speed, the bronze spear begins to whump and snap in the air. She surveys the ruin you've wrought on her town, the wake of bodies and blood you've churned at her feet, and her stance stiffens, her grip tightens on her spear, until her arms are wholly shaking. I haven't clawed my fingers to the bone, I haven't slaughtered those who plague my dreams, just to be washed away by a Kairos damned fate binder. I'll make you regret it, you hear me? I make you regret ever coming here. She slaps her spear against the ground, loud as a whip crack, and her arms shudder from the falls as the haft ricochets back into the air. She laughs, clamorous and throaty and pleased, eager to test her prowess against you. Ha 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 ha! Any last words? How about a truce? Point excitedly. Hey! hey, a three-headed monkey! The last words you're ever going to hear about these. You're going to die now. we're rather about subterfuge than about law. Yeah, we'll try that. It's our dump day. Point excitedly. Hey, what's that over here? A curse dead on her lips, she glances with a jolt toward the horizon. Motherless foot. Punch her in the jaw. Resounding clang spritz the sky as your fist strikes her armored mask. Her neck snaps to the side and she curses anew before spitting blood and teeth at your feet. She trembles with fury, her eyes hot as cinders as she looks back to you. I'm going to enjoy killing you. Spear whipping in her hands, she lunges for you without further warning. And why do we have that thing now? Why are you making a basic stone spike? You should definitely... I don't know. Oh. These instant things here, I hate them. Need a greater renewal. And we need Jacob in here to... on that guy. We need him to stun that guy. Open the gates. Whatever you all do, you're taunted right now. And now I think we'll quicken. Shall we? No, we'll not quicken yet. We'll go for a restoring touch. And I'm sorry. There is... Barik's doing something to Misery? Why? What is he even doing? I mean, he should do something else. Should do that to that guy, I think. He's just running in.
Back here.
We're shooting that one, that's good. Bloodhound badly injured. I'm all for that. Now let's see. Death from above would be nice. A skull splitter would be great. What is Barik still doing? He's controlling stone. Ah. Skull splitter. Yeah, let's finish that one with the skull splitter. We're breaking the wall here. Yeah, that guy should be next, I think. Too much of a nuisance to be left alive. Jacob can do something. He should go for the warrior's respite. Or, on the other hand, we have that artifact, right? Stalwart Surge. That would be very helpful right now. All of them stunned. Good luck fighting now. And we got a level up on Verse. Nice. Let's see how that goes. We have the accuracy. We can go for might. Let's go for might. And Duelist. Mocking Iron, Killing Spree, Fury's Rush. Nah, we want, I think, something simple. How about the piercing arrows? I think that's great. Maybe not great, but good enough. Good enough. That guy is gonna go down. Love it. I'm going to call next soon. So next. Is that a Scarlet Fury? Bit hard to kill. And we'll rather go to Misery. Look at that. She's wounded already. That was what we could do here. Should we attack Misery? Misery is a logical target right now, so put Misery out of her same. Can use that bolt. Debuff her. We should use Warrior's Respite. And maybe even drink something. We don't have anything. That's not good. But we can go for the Quicken now. Ready? That will be even better. We're wounded, but that's okay. We're on her.
I'll do it for the
There we go. Lantry killed her. What a disgrace for her. A healer killed her. What are you doing? I think you should attack from afar. Much more efficient here. So that was Misery. Yeah, let's celebrate a bit. What did we just do? As you slay the last of the Scarlet Chorus gangsters that terrorized Halfgate, the town's residents once more emerge from their homes. Vendor stalls are reopened for business, children play in the rubble-filled roads, and a crowd gathers in the village square as daily life in the ruins of Assur resumes. resumes. Can we now care for that?
Classic example of the Overlord's devastation. Like a battering ram, the edict cleared everything in its path, including the farmlands we need to keep the army supplied.
Hey.
If the Scarlet Chorus lack for provisions, they should stop expanding beyond their means. Short of that, you can eat each other for all I care.
I'd rather snap that lobster shell around you and skewer the fleshy bits underneath.
Oh, you're in for his fleshy bits? Oh my god. What's here? Wow, a lot of stuff going. Blood Chanter leathers. All good Blood Chanter bracers. Iron armor. And the Tearsman spine bow. And what's that? A scarlet notebook. Not that good, probably. Well, anyway, we'll take everything. We'll have a look at it. Yeah, the Blood Chanter braces are just better than the Unbroken Gauntlets. Nice win-win situation. Blood Chanter leathers? So-so. It isn't that good. And we have the bow. And yeah, Fate Finder is of course better. So there we go. And what else? I mean, we're wounded, but we should be able to do this now. The rest of our diplomatic mission. There's a lot of people out there now. Hagrim and Isadora. I think they're friendly now. Let's talk to them. You're the Fatebinder that everyone's been talking about. Is there something I can do for you? What do you do in Halfgate, Hagrim? A little bit of everything, really. Oh, he's a thief. I'm decently handy with tools. Oh yeah, I knew it. And the buildings here, always in need of repairs. Yeah, that's what I would call it too. What can I do for you? What can you tell me about those who would defy Kairos in this realm? The Beastmen are the ones who oppose Kairos in these parts. We are standing on the bones of Asur, but below that are the ruins of the Beastmen ancestral territory. When the realm of Asur rose in power, they enslaved the hideous creatures and consigned them to lives of hard labor. Ever since Cairn fell and the Edict devastated the land, the Beastmen have started to reclaim the Stone Sea. You find yourself in their presence, tread with caution. The Beastmen are territorial and resort to violence with little provocation. Interesting. And Isadora, what do you have to say? Tough times have befallen us. That's good to know. And they're still chanting on to Left Claw. There's Grayson. Who are you, Grayson? Fatebinder, Slayer of Quarmen, Keeper of the Peace, rushes towards you with his arms outstretched and grips you tightly around your waist before realizing his intrusion. What? Quickly backs away and pats away some of the dust he left behind. So many different faces come through this town, but how could I miss the one who single-handedly slayed those gangsters? It was the team. Seems every other day we got new scavengers or artifact hunters or just completely odd folks coming through these parts. Almost unsettling, if you ask me. Anything I can do to help you? Any information you need about the area? First, tell me more about this place, Halfgate. Well, let's see. It used to be called Plainsgate until Cairn came traipsing through and Fatebinder Kallio cast the Edict of Stone on him, destroying thousands of lives in the process. Purses his lips, but you can't win a war without casualties, at least that's what we are told. Even after, we keep getting hit hard by the earthquakes. Lost a lot of people and possessions, but other areas were hit even harder during the Edict. Guess you could say we were in the eye of the storm. Earthquakes? kids these days watch 10 years of auto-monitorological sketches vanish in 20 seconds of smoke? Then tell me all about your slow, leisurely tremors. Oh no. The roads are all shifting and my map's obsolete. Actually, that does sound quite odious. Oh yeah, Landry, give it to them. No matter what happens, you have to keep a positive outlook because it could have been far worse. Things can always be worse, Fatebinder. Yeah, that's a good... Is this man mad? I mean, things can be worse, he's right, but what does that tell us? Tell me what you know about Ken. What is there to say other than he has ruined our lives? We are beset with earthquakes and we've lost so many friends because of him. After the destruction here, he headed out into the Stone Sea. And that's where he still lies, his body turned to stone. The story is he's trapped. That's what's causing the earthquakes. His ongoing death throes are tearing our land apart, but those damn disfavored won't let him die. So we're the ones stuck suffering. Do you know how I could find his body? I hear it's a place called Howling Rock, but I'm not an adventurer. My entire life is here in town, so I wouldn't even know where to begin regarding how to get there. The best I can offer is to tell you to keep asking around town. Someone is bound to know more than I do. How has Cairn's passing affected the settlers of this town? Townsfolk have taken to joining scavenging crews and heading into the Stone Sea to search for artifacts and other treasures. Problem is, the Stone Sea is full of dangers, and those scavengers put their lives in danger each time they leave this settlement. Is there anything I can do to help the scavengers? There's indeed a way you can help, Fatebinder. A scavenging mission went out a few days back, and we haven't seen them since. The longer they're gone, the more I'm sure they won't be coming back. Alright, I'll look for the lost group, and you make it so that you can be productive for Kairos soon, please. This is wonderful news, Fatebinder, thank you. Smiles and grabs your hand, shaking it vigorously. Oh man, this guy. He's so touchy-feely. They were on their way to Stone Down, but no one knows if they even arrived. Let's talk about something else. Is there anything I can do to help you? Any information you need about the area? Yeah, what do you know about the spires in the Stone Sea? Deep in the heart of Beastmen territory, there's one. Those are dangerous parts. You best be watching your back out there. He nods solemnly before continuing. The other is surrounded by those rock worshippers where that colossus of stone finally collapsed. What a stone colossus. Yeah, that giant of an Archon. He kept moaning and groaning as he made his way across the land, left destruction in his wake, and riled up the beastmen something fierce. Believe he fell near the dawning spire? He gives his head a scratch, pondering the situation. Some of the vendors here in town could tell you more. I know they've had some dealings with the scavengers from those areas. What was the Scarlet Chorus doing here? Narfgate. Not much now that you've slain them, but for the rest of the Stone Sea, all I can tell you is they came in promising to help us with the Beastmen, telling everyone they'd take care of the earthquakes. I don't know if they were telling the truth or not, but I do know they've damn near swarmed this realm, claiming it for their Archon of Secrets. And if they can take those wild beasts out, I'm willing to give them all the help they want. Have you seen any disfavored here too? I've not seen any personally, but I've heard that they've set up around Cairn's body at Howling Rock. No one in town wants them around. Everyone here blames them for the ongoing earthquakes. That's all I need to know. Now to this. We'll see about this in the next episode. What's going on here? I'm sure there's still a lot to do. Also with this guy looking like she's now the new town chief or something. And that guy here at the beginning. Maybe also a problem that needs to be solved. Thank you for watching. Happy gaming to you. It's Judgment Day, probably, for this beastman, and we are the law.